What's up, guys? I'm in a oddly good mood. It's Saturday. About to head on to the gym. Got a couple errands I gotta run after the gym, but I don't know, man. I'm like feeling today's energy. A lot of good stuff happening behind the scenes, but I'm gonna keep quiet about that until later in the video. Look alive. Yo, this song, it didn't come out recently, or wait, I think it came out recently. I'm not sure if the music video came out with the song, but like Block Boy featuring Drake, Look Alive, it's been on repeat for the last couple of days for sure. Like definitely a track that I added to my playlist. Whoo, Drake can't miss, bruh. Oh, dang it, too. I'm telling you guys, that song, Look Alive, if you have not heard it, listen to it. Drake, Block Boy, Look Alive. It goes hard, bruh. Tim, I gotta ask you a dead ass question.
What's good,
like, bro? On camera, on the spot.
On the spot.
If I bought a little combo rack for the gym,
yeah,
is it possible to have it here?
Yeah.
Is it possible?
Yeah.
From the man himself?
Yeah.
All right.
It's good, bro.
Great success.
Okay, guys, so you heard it from the man himself. So the plan is to buy a combo rack for the gym. As a power lifter, I will admit that I live in a gym that does not necessarily have the best equipment. So it's like a combo rack is essentially what I use in competition. That's what they use in competition. A combo rack is basically a squat and bench rack at the same damn time. And also it allows people with different heights. Like if someone's taller than me, we can squat at the same time because all we have to do is just adjust the rack heights. So it's like around $1,500 from Texas Strength Systems, but I think I'm gonna buy it today. And it's a good investment. It's a very good investment just for the fact that like the racks around here, it's not that they're bad, but I'd rather be lifting on competition grade equipment. Not kilo plates though. We don't mess with kilo plates around here. America. So we have a 6x3 on bench at an RP of 7. So we have 365 pounds on the bar right now. We got 6. Not 1, not 2, not 3, 6. I got an imaginary hand, an imaginary finger on the side too, but 6 sets of 3. That's a long workout. I'm gonna try to knock this out as fast as I possibly can. 6 sets. Why, Joe? Why? Yo, I'm not even gonna lie, man. For some reason on that last set, 365 felt like I was trying to lift the world. Like it, all of a sudden like fatigue just hit me. And I'm like, yo, that last set, it was just too heavy. I struggled to get that last rep in and I was just like, all right, I got dropped down. But so we dropped down to 350. Currently listening to a Jeff Ross interview on The Breakfast Club. Really good interview, by the way. Surprisingly. I was like, Jeff Ross on The Breakfast Club? Like, that's kind of weird. And he actually cranked out a good 40-minute interview, so that's what I'm listening to. So let's go ahead and get this last. I think we have 2 more sets with 350 pounds. So, 5th set. better. Oh! Yo, I'm like literally laughing at this Jeff Ross interview as I'm working out, but this is the last set. We made it. It actually wasn't that bad. It went by kind of fast. But this is a sixth set. 350 pounds. Three reps. RP is 7.
Russell?
Yeah.
Alright, bro. I'm gonna search you up right now and I'm gonna subscribe to you.
I appreciate it, man. Okay, guys. It's cold as hell. Receive the package, though. So basically, I came to the mall to get a fanny pack. And I got the fanny pack. So now it's time to head on to Target. Oh, my goodness. Oh, man. It's so cold. So cold. Yesterday it was like 75 degrees and now today it's like 40 degrees. And my eyes are super sensitive, so when it's like really cold outside and there's a little bit of wind, my eyes instantly just become watery. Also, Jamba Juice makes amazing matcha green tea smoothies. That was so good. Okay, so we have a little bit of inventory kind of stocked up. This obviously isn't everything that I have, but it's like these are the four different designs that I currently have. And let me explain exactly what's going on right now. Okay, so as I said at the start of this video, I've been working on something kind of like, you know, behind the scenes on the low, and something that I've been pretty excited for going forward. And I'm like, I've just been keeping on the low because I like to just do things like without saying anything, just kind of like make sure I could get it ready and before I actually say something about it. So it's like now that I'm saying it, it just means that we're getting closer and closer to the actual launch date of Sasquatch Socks. Now, Sasquatch Socks is just basically a sock company that I started, and we're like in the finalizing stages of what I want it to be. So it's like, you know, getting the inventory in, it's getting a lot of stuff done, and like, you know, just stuff behind the scenes. It's like, it's fun and it's exciting. And as you guys know, I love socks, and it's just cool to kind of like translate that into something that I can share with you guys. So, you know, Sasquatch Socks, man, it's coming. I'm telling you, man, it's coming. So I actually have an Instagram page for it. So if you guys want to go ahead and follow that, I'll have the link in my description box. But I'm excited about it, man. It should be launching in the next maybe like 2 months or so. But that's what I've been kind of just like, you know, chilling a little about. But I'm going to go ahead and tell you guys because, you know, y'all the fam, and I got to include y'all. So, yeah, I'm like, I keep looking at the socks and stuff like that because like I'm just kind of proud about it. And it's like, it's just something I'm kind of like passionate about. It's like something that kind of gets my gears going. So once again, guys, if you guys want to follow the page, kind of keep up with the updates and stuff like that, it's going to be Sasquatch_socks, and the Instagram link will be in my description box. But your boy's tired. It's Sunday. It's actually just a little under 3 weeks for the Arnold. And tomorrow, we're gonna start getting serious. Tomorrow we're gonna be squatting. So I'll see you guys then. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are squatting. Now we are right under 3 weeks out from my powerlifting meet. So fatigue has already hit me. Your boy's tired. Like my body's just feeling beat up, but that's perfectly fine and I'm adjusting. So today's workout is supposed to be a heavy single at RP 7 to 8, then a top volume set of 5 at an RP of 8, then we drop down and do 4 sets of 5 at RP 6 to 7, I believe. I'll go back and check the schedule, but that's what we're supposed to be doing for today's workout. So here's that heavy single, 625 pounds, RP of 7 to 8. Thank you. Yo, so that single at 625 pounds, it like, it was heavy. It was heavy for sure. Like, once again, fatigue is setting in, so it's like, each rep just feels like I'm dying. But I think that was around an RPA 8. Like, I think I could have got that for two more reps. So now we're going to drop down and do the top volume set at RPE of 8. So we have 555 pounds on the bar right now. So we got five reps for 555 pounds. And then we're going to drop down to maybe like 535 and finish up the rest of this workout with a 4x5 at an RPE of, I think, like 6 or 7. I just know that today's workout is going to be hard as hell. So let's get to it. Okay guys, so that first set with 555 pounds was good. So if you guys notice, I was going slower for each rep. Like, I was taking my time and setting it up. So last week on Friday, I sent Joey my reps and he's like, yo Russ, these look great, but I want you to focus on going forward is trying to slow up the process whenever you're setting for squat. Quick thing to take note of is when I come up on squat, the bar shakes, right? So what he's basically trying to tell me to do is let the weight settle and make it easier upon myself. What happens whenever I go down and try to squat while the weight is unsettled, that means I'm gonna be expending energy to settle the weight and get into proper position. He's like, yo, save energy, and at the top of each rep, take your time, let the weight settle, gather yourself, brace into the belt, and then begin the squat. And it actually was a lot easier for me this time around. So for the rest of this workout, I'm gonna be applying what Joey said. So let's finish up this 4x5. We got 535 pounds. Let's work, man. So we got the Sasquatch socks on them with the 98 Gundams. You feel me? With the fanny pack and the Sandlot shirt. Never seen Sandlot in my life, but you know, it's kind of tough, so I had to wear it. One time for the one time. Oh, one time for the one time. Gang, gang. Let me show y'all this. I just whipped up. Look at this. We got the bison burgers on deck. Now, I've just been put onto bison burgers. Honestly, bison tastes amazing. So it's like 90-10 bison meat. Then we have the pita chips, but this is gonna be the post-workout. Oof, bruh, that looks so good. All right, thank you guys so much for tuning in today's video. This video is coming to end. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Like always, if you guys like this video, please like, comment, share, subscribe. Get better today. I'm out. Mamacita, cita, cita.